My name is Dr. Emmanuel Mushimiyimana. I have a PhD in African Studies and Master's degree in Governance and Development, and a bachelor's degree in Political Science. And I'm a lecturer from the University of Rwanda. I teach in the College of Arts and Social Sciences and in the School of Governance, and specifically in the Department of Political Science and International Relations. Today I'm going to teach the course of Integrity Systems in Rwanda. To introduce the module, we are going to start with the following, especially the aim and the objective of the course. This module and especially this unit teach the integrity systems in the country of Rwanda. It was designed from the first year students of the University of Rwanda in order to equip them with knowledge that contributes to being a good citizen with good values, what we call in Kinyarwanda indangagaciro Nyarwanda. The unit provides the knowledge on integrity in Rwanda as a whole, ubunyangamugayo, ubupfura for instance, and strengthens the concept of anti-corruption or corruption-free society that Rwanda aspires to have. Rwandans, like any other society, cannot prosper if the citizens and especially the elites have no integrity. As a country torn by genocide against Tutsi, bad governance and irresponsible leadership in armies, government, businesses, and social structures in the past, integrity is deemed necessary to awaken transparency, accountability, honesty, to building new developmental citizens and to empower people in a journey of transformation. Integrity or anti-corruption studies and systems in Rwanda lead to building a moral society ready to overcome intractable hatred of the past. Intractable hatred here means the long and deep hatred between groups of citizens. It creates a more responsible and accountable students and citizens generally. The university educates and trains future allies that will be public servants, private businessmen and women, accountants, policemen, managers, medical doctors, engineers, and leaders in all sectors of the country. And so, in these all sectors, we need integrity. We need leaders and public servants which have integrity and values of integrity to achieve their daily work and activities. Without this achievement, the scientific knowledge that the university graduates are supposed to have become obsolete or maybe disastrous, as Rwandans witnessed during 1994 Tutsi genocide. Rwanda is located in the region where there is high level of corruption in public institutions, dictatorship and embezzlement of public and private funds. For instance, we see some cases of corruption in Tanzania, Kenya, Burundi, or other neighboring countries, or in general sub-Saharan countries. So these countries have a high level of corruption comparing to Rwanda this time, and which gives hope of integrity system and the integrity values in the country. However, this can influence the Rwandan allies to behave the same way as generally in Kenya, Rwanda we say ihene mbi ntawe yizirika ho iye. The proximity fact can also affect Rwandan's elite. That's why we have to prepare Rwandan's elite, and as far as any foreign student who may be enrolled in the University of Rwanda, to start integrity values at younger age. To achieve this, Rwanda have established institutions and organizations that work together to promote integrity. This is called integrity system. This network of activities will remain formalized and structured since 2013 through the creation of National Editorial Commission. In this module, Unit of Integrity System will discuss the following questions. What are the institutions and agencies in Rwanda that facilitate integrity? How do they work together to foster integrity? What did they achieve so far, and what are the remaining challenges they face? I repeat the questions that we are going to address. What are the institutions and agencies in Rwanda that facilitate integrity? How do they work together to foster integrity? And what did they achieve so far, as well as what the remaining challenges they face? Those are the key points that will drive our discussion or teaching of today. We are going to start with the point number two, which is institutions and agency of integrity in Rwanda. Let's start with political institutions, and mainly the key point, the ideology of the Rwandanness. After the genocide against the Tutsi in 1994, Rwanda government abolished the governance based on ethnic divides and discrimination and the Kigandruga regional disparities. To achieve so, the new ideology replaced the former ones. For instance, the Ndumunye Rwanda ideology, I'm Rwandan, aims at abolishing the politicization of the ethnic identity, which hinged on the Hutu majoritarianism and Hutu power created by former post-independence Rwandan government elites. See the case, for instance, of Aposoma, MDL, and MRND, and its satellite parties like CDR and other power parties in Rwanda from 1950s up to 1994. Drove to discrimination policies. This Hutu power ideology drove to discrimination policies against the other existing citizens, including Tutsi and Hutu. The founder of ideology of Hutu majoritarianism considered that Tutsi mainly as outsiders and at the extreme level as foreigners who merit no rights in the country. The Hutu, who was considered as naturally the indigenous, were kept marginalized for land and deprived for any right to the property, including land. The other hypocrisy is that the government used to claim the right of Hutu majority, but on the contrary, they created generalized poverty and illiteracy in a bigger number of peasants in the country. Only few people had access to education and to other public benefits. The state led by Hutu extremists denied free and meritocratic access to education and economic development opportunities to the mass they claimed to promote. This process of ethnicization and politicization of quota system created structure and systemic injustice, teaching people to use force to rob the property of others, especially in hated and marginalized groups of Tutsi and Hutu. This led to massive land grabbing and the refusal to repatriate Rwandan refugees who were abroad for more than 30 years. This phenomenon continuously led to gluttonous, hypocrites, and arrogant leaders who denied all forms of being servant to their own citizens, but on the contrary, betraying them. Some witnesses of genocide survivors shows that public servants and even private ones among civil society organizations betrayed them as if they were not Rwandans. For instance, we see cases where some medical doctors, some religious leaders, some army and police refused to protect and give safety services to people in need. The state and civil society were merely led by elites who were mostly out of integrity. The core values of Ndumunye Rwanda policy then is to bring back values and dignity of all Munyarwanda citizens without distinction. It is implemented both nationally and in Rwandan diaspora abroad. Nationally, there is teaching and gatherings that are planned for dissemination of unity policy and national values of being Rwandans with integrity. Itorero is one of the institutions that aim at fostering the dissemination and implementation of this policy. Abroad, Rwanda Day means the visit of the president and his delegation to diaspora abroad and help them to discuss issues of national unity and development of Rwanda and enhancing new values of being Rwandan, even if a citizen chose by his will to remain abroad, as Rwanda accepted double citizenship. It calls upon the diaspora to be participative in the national development process. The government of Rwanda abolished the politicization of ethnic identity. It created the government of unity and reconciliation to abolish intractable hatred among Rwandan society and also to heal wounds of hypocrisy that was created by former governments. Rumunyarwanda is a declaration that one is no longer ethnic driven but rather state driven. It is a set of values such as patriotism by claiming to be a citizen of Rwanda first. It is also having the value of unity ideology by feeling equal citizens and joining effort to combat divisionism and reconciliation by pardoning and working together for present and the future of the country. Rumunyarwanda also brings in inclusion where everyone counts in the developmental process of his nation. To implement that ideology, the institutions were created such as Ngando, Itiroriyugu, Abarinzi b'Igihango, and the official recognition of national heroes who had shown values to work for a nation without division, like King Rudahigwa, who was a king who fought against discrimination among Rwandans and wanted independence of the country from colonialist Belgian or Belgian dominion. We have also other models like General Fred Gisel-Rwigema, who was fighting the Habyarimana regime that had refused to repatriate thousands of Rwandan refugees who were scattered in Uganda, Tanzania, Burundi, DRC and other countries from 1959 to 1994. We have also other role models like Agatha Uwilingiyimana, who was the first prime minister, who was against nepotism and segregation of MRND government during the multi-party system in Rwanda in the early 1990s and who was eventually killed by the said government in 1994 together with a number of Tutsi citizens who were in the country. The ideology also embedded the activities of remembering, dignifying and honoring the victims of Hutu majoritarian driven policies, including political and civil society leaders and even some citizens with integrity who were victims of Nazi-like hypocrisy of extremist political leader of MRND. Building the institution like Inzibutso, Genocide Memorial Centers, from national level to local level, awakened the citizens of Rwanda to remember the past characterized by lack of integrity and fairness to their neighbors and co-citizens, to build a new Rwanda which gets rid of injustice and animosity, even cruelty. Therefore, integrity is one of the drivers of politics in Rwanda, where everyone must count, and where Rwandan citizens are fair to his co-citizen without looking at all differences. The system of consider that whoever promotes the past divisive ideology is an enemy of the state and the survival of a nation. The first enemy of a nation, according to the current government of Rwanda, includes ethnic divisionism, discrimination, colonialism, and the genocide ideology. Integrity then is considered as a political solution and ideological driver that can bring back dignity, accountability, fairness among citizens, and the survival of Rwanda. Integrity according to Rwandan constitution. That is a point which we are going to discuss as well. What does the constitution of Rwanda say about integrity? The constitution of the Republic of Rwanda of 2003 as revised in 2015, is a founding father or founding mother of the value of integrity in Rwanda. Its preamble shows the important commitment of Rwandan society toward integrity. The first is the establishment of the rule of law. The rule of law means that no one is superior to the law, and so no one is supposed to abuse or go unpunished once he or she transgresses the provisions of law. Because of most of Rwandan's officials, as mentioned above, were characterized by going beyond the limits of law and social norms by transgressing other rights, the rule of law is paramount strategy to safeguard integrity in the society of Rwanda. The constitution stipulates that Rwandans are committed to building a state governed by the rule of law, based on the respect for the human rights, freedom, and on the principle of equality of all Rwandans before the law, as well as equality between men and women. You can find that in Official Gazette number special of 24th of December 2015, page 26. Indeed, the Rwandan constitution admits the commitment to building a state governed democratically. As specific in the constitution, the system of Rwanda is based on consensual and pluralistic democracy. There are a number of systems in the world, such as constitutional democracy or liberal democracy. In constitutional democracy, for instance, people elect their leaders and take political decisions basing on their territorial differences or ethnic denominations or ethnic quota systems. We find such cases in Switzerland or in neighboring Burundi. In liberal democracy, winner takes all and there is no power sharing. Therefore, Rwanda chose consensual democracy for the purpose. In the liberal, for instance, in the liberal democracy system, the political party which has lost election does not equally have opportunity to enter into government, and so wait until it competes again next time. On the contrary, consensual democracy that Rwanda adopted is a system based on the fact that decisions are discussed and agreed consensually by different parties, both in the government position and in opposition. Opposition parties, rebels, or other factions are not neglected in Rwanda. Political system and political decision-making process once they want to cooperate. To illustrate the consensual democracy in Rwanda, we take the case of political parties that work together in Rwanda. The RPF parties, though has a bigger legitimacy due to the law it had in stopping genocide against the Tutsi and forms of social injustice in Rwanda, lead the country together with others that are accepted in the country. The constitution provides only 50% of the state seats in government for winning party, and that other parties occupy the rest of the seats. This shows a fair power sharing view and is considered among the best system globally. There have been not only the inclusion of political parties in government, but even the rebel groups, especially the FDRR leaders, who accepted to follow the new ideology of New Rwanda and unity and reconciliation, have been repatriated, inserted, and reintegrated both in politics, defense, and the society in general. Consensual decision-making have been a guiding principle and value of Rwandan government. The only exclusion have been to people who have committed genocide, who still have genocide ideology, or who seriously threaten national and regional security, and have not accepted to stop such activities. Others among their rights have been able to work together for national decision-making. Pluralistic governments, it is a government which accepts the differences of ideology and behaviors of the people in a society apart from the genocide ideology or other bad conduct that are not allowed by law in the culture in Rwanda. For instance, Rwanda is tolerant to beliefs, different values, and culture that manifest in the country. the formation of different political parties, pressure groups, and adherence to religious and other forms of association are allowed. It was proven that Rwanda is one of the countries of East Africa which is more open and have no taboos against minority groups such as women, albinos, historically marginalized groups of people, and so on and so forth, compared to other countries of sub-Saharan Africa. There has been adoption of different laws that promote those minority groups and policy and action to promote minority groups such as women and historically marginalized persons. The consensual system of governance aims at strengthening unity and reconciliation, good governance, development, social justice, tolerance, and resolution of the problem through dialogue. You can find that also in Official Gazette, number special of 24th December 2015, page 26. The other commitment of Rwandan society through its constitution is the prevention of genocide and the upholding of family morality and patriotism. The constitution stipulates that Rwandans are committed to preventing and punishing the crimes of genocide, fighting genocide negationism and revisionism, eradicating genocide ideology and all its manifestation, revisionism and discrimination based on ethnicity, region, or other ground. This quotation is from Official Gazette of 24th December 2015, page 26 again. The Constitution of Rwanda recognized the family morality as well. Patriotism, the value of Rwanda hinges upon the fact that development and national cohesion start in the family. The general interest results from collective interest of individuals. Being a child, old or young, does not prevent you to get more security and protection that everyone have right to. On patriotism, the people need to serve their country with zeal, striving to move it ahead regionally and internationally, and striving to eat economic competitiveness, security, and prosperity. State organs and agents should serve the common interest. This means that public agents should focus on common interest rather than individual crony or private interest. A thing that previously destroyed the country through the creation of new patrimonialism, or commonly known as system of akazu or mziso system, or other forms of favoritism, ekimenyane. Public service delivery and recruitment should be meritocratic, and the use of public funds should be rational according to the constitutional world. The Rwandan constitution sticks on territorial sovereignty as well, political integrity, right to choose forms of government, leadership integrity, leading for common interest, being a servant, gukorera abaturage, leading not to dictate, kuyobora atari ugutegeka, and tolerance and resilience, kwihanganira no kwihangana. The constitution and national rules stipulate all of these in different articles and in more details. Article 10 of the constitution highlights further the fundamental principles of Rwanda society, such as explained above. These are six principles and are as follows. First, prevention and punishment of the crime of genocide, fighting against denial and revision of genocide, as well as eradication of genocide ideology and all its manifestation. The second fundamental principle is eradication of discrimination and revisionism based on ethnicity, region, or any other ground, as well as promotion of national unity. The third fundamental principle is equitable power sharing. The fourth is building state governed by the rule of law, a pluralistic democratic governance, equality of all Rwandans and between men and women, which is affirmed by women occupying at least 30% of position in decision-making organs. The fifth principle is building a state committed to promotion of social welfare and establishing appropriate mechanism for equal opportunity to social justice. The sixth is constant quest for solution through dialogue and consensus. That was on Official Gazette, also 24th December 2015, page 34 to 35. The Constitution also talks about right to apply homegrown solution to Rwandan's problems.